Hey guys, thank you very much for tuning in to another episode. Well, episode, review, whatever. With TF Customizer. This is my review of the Studio Series Rampage. I mean, this guy is just epic. When I mean epic, I mean he's just all kinds of badass. He really is. I mean, the sculpt on him, as you can see, like, attention to detail on the arms, the hands, back and front is just amazing. I mean, obviously, he doesn't need to stand up. There was an original showing of him where his leg split into two. However, it's not great, to be honest. And I think they scrapped that idea. I mean, the whole like seam and everything like that is still there for it, as you can see. But I think they just scrapped the whole thing because none of that comes apart. Anyway, what we're going to do is let's get into transforming him. So, transformation process on this guy, it's not easy. I think the most complicated thing is the tracks. But it's a lot simpler than Longhaul, who you saw in my last video. So first things first is this little bit here. Let's fold that in, and then this just simply pulls off. So there we go. That's what you should have, is like a three-piece shuriken with that other one tucked in. Yeah, I do apologize about the paint on my fingers, by the way. That's just what you get when you're being a customizer. Anyway, so first things first, we're going to take this. As you can see, there's a hole here in the bottom, and that just simply goes into the cab, like so, as you can see. And then, like I said, the most difficult part of this is just the tracks, the caterpillar tracks. So you need to straighten the arm out, and then these top two fingers here, best way to show you is that this one has to go round that way. Just make sure you straighten that bit out. Oh, these bits do tend to be really sticky when it comes to transforming him into his vehicle mode. Surprisingly, that happened way too easy. It's not happened like that before, so I'm gonna take it how it comes. These fingers here, they can just stay the way that they are. Just make sure that, because obviously those fingers move them bits of the track, so just make sure that you just fetch it round and just keep them as close as possible. And then this finger over here, you have to move this piece out of the way first. So that's just come from round here. And then that has to come round also. And just fetch it to about here-ish. So this like red bit's in line with the back claw. And then fold that back up underneath, like so. There we go. And then we can put that track down, but do not lock it in yet. So in fact, let's just keep it like this. So that whole process, you just need to do the same again over on the other side. So just fetch that in so you can see. So this one, as you can see, straighten the fingertip out, fetch that down over the top, like so. There we go. So obviously it makes the caterpillar bar, and then this one on the other side again, where that wheel is, just grab the wheel, pull it down out of the way, pull this other claw in a bit further, about there, like I said, not too far up, then push this back in, and then there we go. That's the caterpillars pretty much done. So as for the head simply just goes down like so. It's like, if where that it'll be hard to show you guys, but where that, here we go, you see it? So where that like grill bit is there, his fangs see either side of that. So like so, and there we go. Nice. He's also got a double articulation neck, so he's got quite a lot of play in his head. So let's put him back. And then all we're going to do is they're just going to take this entire section. So keep these open. And you just ratchet that down like so. Oh, in fact, no. That's the wrong grill. That's the right grill. You see where the two holes are? Yeah. So there you go. That's where his face locks in. Like that. So it's just really simple. And then just under here, you should have two pegs now. So you turn so that the caterpillars are straight. Like so. When I can get them in, that is. There we go, that's it. So we've got them both in, as you heard. And then it's just a matter of neating it up then. So them two bits that you can see, what I've been moving in and out of the way, let's fetch them round. This is the reason why the caterpillar tracks still need to be loose, because then these parts here, these come down and then they just lock into it quite nicely. Same with this one. Down, cross, simple as that. So there we go. So it should be like pretty much flush, and this, taking this, turn it round. So there's two pegs just here, one there and one there. This is actually really difficult to do, it really is actually. Because my base plate, for some reason, one of the holes isn't... You know what? I'm not even going to force it. So, because I have had it where I've just had the Caterpillar tracks fitted over the top of it. Anyway, see how it goes there. So there we go. And there you have it. That is pretty much the transformation of the Studio Series long... nearly said long haul. It's because I was talking about him earlier. Rampage. I don't actually know what this bit's for. This is going to be... That's going to be interesting. Maybe that's going to be for... Serve a purpose for... Overload. Maybe. Because Overload, I believe, serves quite a proportion of him, of Devastator. So, there we go. So, that is pretty much the transformation for that guy. Another thing that we can look at now that we've seen him in his robot to vehicle, then we're going to Gestalt mode again. So the leg mode, the left leg of Devastator, and then we'll have him back into his final mode, which is the robot mode again. So this one's a little bit more tricky than long haul, I must admit. So first things first, what you want to do with this guy is the bits where I said we need to spring open to slide these, is that those you completely move out of the way. I have actually got a bit of a problem with mine sometimes when it's transforming. Someone's told me to write to Hasbro about it, but to be honest with you, I'm really not that fussed. It still transforms, still works. I'm happy at that. So the transformation of this one is a bit more involved. So now that we've moved those out of the way, you want to uncouple the tank treads again. Here we go. Here we go. This thing needs to come completely off and just dispose of that to one side. Maybe it's going to have a secondary purpose. I'm not entirely sure. But one thing I can definitely say is it doesn't serve a purpose right at this very second. So what you do with these is that the treads will need to pay attention when I'm transforming. I watched a video myself on how to transform these, and it just took a little bit more in-depth thinking than what I thought it would need. So first things first, now that you've got to this stage, is move the entire cab up. So you should have something like this. These parts, there's two flaps here on the side of the cab. So just there, look. There we go. Those need to be open. And then this is where it gets meaty. So keep that down there. Then you need to take this finger, move it out of the way. Same with that wheel. Move that out of the way. make sure that is perfectly straight, so you've got something like this. And then that entire section, oh, sorry, forgot about the other side. So open that up again, and then move this finger upwards, I believe, upwards. No, sorry, all the way around. Does it go all the way around? Or does it go, no, yeah. So all the way around. So as though you were making the hand again. So what you should have is something like that, a bit of a mess. So you should have wheel, claw, tread. Claw facing downwards. On the other side, that needs to be open. And then this one, this claw, straight down. Because then what happens is that... No! What am I doing wrong? Sorry for taking this thing off the camera, guys. I am actually stuck as to what to do. Oh, hang on. Which one of these moves the... Ah, that's it. Right. Sorry about that. Right, so okay. Like I said, you should have a mess. Should have one like that. One like that. So this claw that I said was straight here. That one. You need to lift that one up to unlock the top bit. That was it. So then it twists all the way around. So it looks like this. But first, before you do that, you take that, flip that all the way around to... Does it flip all the way around to the other side? It should do. This is what I mean by the treads are really quite tricky. And you've only done it a handful of times. So that lifts up. So that goes round, like so. Oh, that's it. So yeah, you just spin it round. Flip that round like so. Believe it needs to be on the other side when it's over here. So that is it, basically. So there you go. So do you hear that snap inside? So it needs to look like that. As difficult as what that looked, that is how it needs to look, sadly. So tidy it up so you know that you're not causing yourself any problems. So lock that in. Fetch this finger back round. Lock that in. So there we go. And then... lock this one back in when he spins it the right way around. There we go. So this time round, it should actually look like that. So, if you didn't follow that the first time round because it was just a jumbled mess, don't panic. We're going to do this side now. So here we go. So starting from this side, track open. This is the one that I have trouble with. Hasbro, why am I having this problem? So anyway, make sure that's open as well. Let me just take this off the camera, guys. There's part of me that does want to take it back to the store. It's only this piece. Right. There we go. So I have got it off. Finally. So, as I mentioned before, I was so rudely interrupted by that piece. So, this bit here will be down here like this. And then obviously there will be the tank track. So all you do is you unhinge that, straighten that out, pull this up here like so, and then all the way around. So you've got a straight bit. Same with this part here. So you pull that all the way around so it's out of the way. Then this bit, pull that down. I'm really sorry about the pause of concentration as well. As everyone knows, Studio Series figures can be quite expensive, and I don't want anything to happen to this guy. So, right, and then you have to pull this up like so. So you've got that sort of shape. That then unhinges the spindle. When the spindle's unhinged, that will allow it to go all the way around, like so. And then you put that foot, again, same as what we did with the other. Is that right? Hell no, of course it's not right, because Goober Boy has put it on the wrong way around. Right, there we go. Sorry, this spins round like this. So then you should have doesn't make sense now. Because that's supposed to go like that. Underneath. It won't go all the way though. Now we have a problem. I'm really screwing this up. I'll need to just have a look at this guy. On this side. Right. Right. So that's open. Well. Right, hang on a minute. So, right, okay. So another learning curve for me. So let's put this guy back now. Like that. So that's snapped in. Yep, you're all back together. Nice one. There we go. Sorry about that, people. This one is the worst one I have ever done. So, to be able to get that all the way around, is that it's got to be the part where you have to slide it up to fetch it round. You have to then close it to fetch it the rest of the way round. I don't know why it does that, or why it's made like that. That part of it doesn't make sense to me. None. No sense whatsoever. Right, so there we go. So, just tidy it up again. Ugh. We will get there eventually. Like I said, Rampage, for me, is the worst one. Personally, anyway. That's what I think. He's a great figure, but to get him in his Gestalt mode is terrible. I've just closed it all, and I've not even put the caterpillar treading right. Do you know what? I'm just going to stop this video and just get this part done. To be honest. Because it's really ticking me off. Hey, right, sorry about that, guys. That was absolutely terrible, and I do apologise. Next time I do a review, I'm going to make sure that I definitely know how I transform it first. Right, I've only read I've just gone back over the instructions, and there was one bit that I was missing. It's always the case. Right. So now that you've got that kind of shape, it's just a matter, and you've tidied it up and everything and put it back together to how it's supposed to be and yada, 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 yada. Yeah, you heard all that before. Right, so here we go. So the claws, these bits, there is actually a slider pin. So you actually have to put one above the other and then push it down. Like so. So then you've got that shape. And then, as everybody knows, there we go. I think that's how it ends up looking. So this part here, which was the torso, you just have to unpeg that, lift it up like so. So it should just be a matter of like that, and there you go. That is basically your Devastator right leg. One of the things that I did forget, that's just this head. It has to go like that and twist round so that it goes underneath these feet. Underneath the claws. So put the claws back together, peg those back in if they have come loose. Put that down like so. There we go. So that's better. So that's it, that's more solid now. So how everybody knows when they've seen him, that leg's bent backwards like so. I don't know where that needs to sit at the moment until we've got a release of Overload. But that is the official looking of it in the instructions. So yeah, that is the Gestalt mode. Sorry, it took me so long to get there. I do apologise. But I can promise you that getting from this mode back into his robot mode is a lot easier than what I made that look. So let's do that, shall we? Let's not waste any more time. So there we go. That's the stand, so just open that, and we need to obviously flat that back down, close these sides in, and then open that, open his arms, move those out of the way so that they're completely flush with the bucket of the bulldozer. And then just fetch the ratchet and the torso back into line. So you should already have that already, pretty much. And then you just simply unpeg, fetch round, move that one out of the way, and then again, fetch that round. There we go. So what you need to do is we're twisting these arms back round, essentially, to how they were before. And then we're... There we go. Fetch that round. Fetch that round, all the way around, lock it back in. And then there we go. So, oh, by the way, that tread opens and shuts like I showed before. And then put this wheel mechanism. It does peg in, so you should just hear it like that. And then the arm is essentially just like that. Just on a ratchet and what have you. So, fingers. And then, just trying to find where, that's where he moves there. And then, same again with this one. So, all you do is move that, move this, move that one, unhook that, pull this round, and then that should allow for that. Don't forget, there's that wheel part there as well. Don't forget to unhinge that. That twists all the way around. Like so. Like that. Peg that back up. There we go. So fingers. Like so. Fetch this piece back down because that's what connects into his stand. There we go. It's got to do the same here. Like that. Plug him back into his stand, and there you go. So that is pretty much it. So that's the Studio Series Rampage. My opinions, great figure, really great figure. However, the this part, seems to be that it's a thing with Rampage and Long Haul, the whole difficulty with arms. Seems to be a big issue. But it is what it is. I mean, there's not too much looseness in them, as you can see. He's on a ratchet as well. So, I mean, you can stand him how you want, really. So, depends how you're feeling at the time. So, but yeah, that is my Studio Series Rampage. Great figure. Again, a really strong, stable figure as we've discovered, and the only issues that we have with it is the arms. Getting the arms transformed to go into Gestalt mode. Really happy with him. Great paint job, great sculptures on them yet again. Again, I only have problems with the arms. But to be honest, it looks as though Overload could be the main trouble causer out of all the Constructicons, realistically. And when someone said why, I was like, well, he is, well, he's basically the bottom side, bottom part of the torso. So when they transformed in the movie, that's that we didn't see a lot of that. And then we got some concepts of Overload, which I'm going to be showing you in the video. And it's just going to be difficult to grasp how he's going to transform. Like, his trailer is an articulated dump loader. So after all that, it's making me wonder, like, right, in the concepts and the samples that we saw, we've got the trailer, then there's the extension for the cement mixer where the vortex is. If anybody realised that. So yeah, we have we've got a lot to think about on Overload, and I personally think that his transformation is going to be the worst of them all. So we'll see how difficult it's going to be anyway once they're released. So apparently they're having a lot of problems. So when we do get them, I'm going to be ecstatic, really ecstatic, because it means I can finish Devastator. But until that time, the studio series are just going to be on display just for the time being. And then I will do a full video of them all being combined. So, right, after that absolutely horrendous review, great figure, very solid, very sturdy, a lot of problems that could be fine-tuned with the arms. Gestalt mode, not really anything to write home about. But we probably won't know what the full extent of that is until we've got the rest of Devastator released. So, but other than that, if anybody asked me, should I buy it? My answer obviously is going to be yes. I would buy it. Well, obviously, I would buy it because I have bought it. And just take your time with the transformation of it. And just make sure that you've got the patience as well. So, righto. So after all of that, enjoy the rest of your day. This is me signing out, and next time I transform a Transformer, I will make sure I am 100% certain, like I was 100% certain before, how to transform it. Okay, guys, right. Enjoy the rest of your days. Peace out.